Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive magazine. Thanks for joining me in this lesson presented to you by our friends at Elixir Strings. This is one of a series of lessons that aims to supercharge your practice through the use of what I'm going to call compound guitar exercises. These are essentially exercises that address multiple areas of your guitar playing all at once. So let's say, for example, you invest 10 minutes of practice time into one of these exercises and it addresses four different areas of your practice time that you need to address separately. Otherwise, you're actually getting about 40 minutes worth of practice for your 10 minute time investment, which sounds pretty good to me. So let's check out today's exercise. Sounds like this. Now I refer to this as the ninth chord Pima relay because it uses this Pima technique, which is going to be thumb, index, middle, and then annular, that's your ring finger, fancy name, on the middle four strings. So we've got A, D, G, and B. That's not a huge exercise, but we'll talk about how you can vary that in a moment. And in the left hand, what we have going on is a relay of ninth chords that challenges your ability to shift fingers while keeping other fingers static. Now, the real trick with this is to keep all the chords ringing as long as you possibly can. So let's talk about what's going on. We're going to start way up here on this G major 9 chord. Now what we have going on here essentially is finger 2 on A fret 10, finger 1 is going to be on fret 9 on the D string, finger 3 is on B fret number 10, and finger 4 is on G fret number 11. It's a lovely chord and it sounds like this. It's a lovely sounding chord, but the next step for us is to take this major 7th note here, which is this 11th fret on the G string, and shift it down to a flatted 7th. And the way we do that is by shifting finger 3 up a string onto G10, and finger 4 goes back to where finger 3 was on B10. So we've had this shape, we now have this shape. We've got 10, 9, 10, and 10. We get a G dominant 9, which sounds like this. Following that, we'll slide our first finger down one fret to turn this into a minor 9, and this is going to give us finger 1 on D fret number 8, and then finger 2, 3, and 4 are remaining on fret 10 on the A string, G string, and B strings respectively, which gives us this. From here, we're going to deftly slide finger 2 and finger 3 down one fret to give us an F sharp 7 sharp 9 chord, which is the Hendrix chord, if you've got any interest in that sort of thing. It's going to essentially give you finger 2 on A fret number 9, finger number 1 is going to go onto, or rather it's going to stay on D fret number 8, finger 3 is on G fret number 9, and finger 4 is on B fret number 10, and we'll play it like this. So one more time, those chords in sequence, we have G major 9, G dominant 9, G minor 9, and then F sharp 7 sharp 9. From here, we keep finger 2 planted on this F sharp note, finger 1 stays where it is, but finger 3 and 4 switch strings on their respective frets, which gives us an F sharp major 9, and thus the relay continues in sequence like this. And it just goes round and round and round for as long as you like. Now, we did talk about some variations that you can use to practice this. And what you can do with this to enhance the kind of like bang for your buck is to use different fingerings with your right hand, or rather different picking patterns with your right hand. For argument's sake, let's try one that goes like this. Now, the actual pattern you choose is kind of up to you. It depends what you want to work on. In this case, I selected a pattern that helps me work on alternating between my second and third fingers and my right hand, my middle and ring fingers. This gives me thumb, index, middle, ring, middle, index. But you can choose any pattern that you want. So in a nutshell, this Pima ninth chord relay is going to give you the ability to focus on moving some fingers while retaining a static position with other fingers. It's also going to drill your ninth chords because they sound nice. It's going to get you playing up here in the dusty end where, let's be honest, we don't spend enough time as acoustic guitar players. And it's also an excuse to work on your various right hand patterns. So there you go, guys. Of course, if you're going to be practicing all these scales, you'll want a fresh set of strings because they do sound best and they feel best. Easiest way to give your guitar a bit of a spruce up is to change the strings. And if you're going to be practicing a whole ton, consider a set of Elixirs because they'll last for ages. That's what Elixirs do, and they'll sound great the whole time. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and I will see you next time.